Hello, I am Professor Amit Nerulkar, and today we are going to focus on one of the important concept of network layer. We would be talking about IP options. So when I'm talking about IP options, as you can see on your screen, there are multiple options available. The first option which is we will be talking about is a single byte option. Now a single byte option, you have two options. The first option known as no operation, second option known as end of option. The first option which is no operation, it is actually used for padding purpose. So it is used for alignment purpose. Whereas when I'm talking about end of option, this option would be talking about when the option to intimate the user that the options have ended, and whatever you will be reading after this option would be nothing but your data. Now in case of multi-byte options, there are four different options available. The first option known as record route, the second option known as a strict source route, the third option known as a loose source route, and finally the last option known as a timestamp. So when I'm talking about the first option known as a record route, so if A is sending any packet to B, in case of record route, whatever routers the packet is visiting, their IP address would be recorded in the IP option. If I'm using strict source route, then for example, when I'm talking about a record route, for example, A is sending packet to B and is visiting router R1, router R2, router R3, and then it is reaching B, then whenever the packet goes to R1, it will enter its IP address, then it will go to R2, it will enter its IP address, then it will go to R3, it will enter its IP address, and then it would go to B. In case of strict source route, the sender will only tell which all routers the packet should visit. As the name says, strict, the packet can neither visit any extra router other than the specified, neither packet can drop any of the routers which are being mentioned. So if the route says A, R1, R2, R3, B, then the packet has to follow A, R1, R2, R3, B. If it visits any extra router, it would be discarded. If it skips any of the mentioned router, it would be discarded. The lower version of the strict source route I'll be talking about is loose source route. It says it has to visit the mentioned routers, that is R1, R2 and R3. It is still okay if it visits some extra routers. And when I'm talking about timestamp, it says whenever the packet is going to the router, router will put its IP along with the timestamp when the packet has received at that particular router. So your timestamp can be actually simply packet will be entering only the timestamp, or the packet would be entering IP and the timestamp, or it is the combination of timestamp with the strict source route. So what happens with strict source route? It has to visit only the specified router. In case of timestamp plus strict source route, it will visit the specified router and enter the respected timestamp. So this was all about the different IP options available, the single byte and multi-byte. So visit my channel and subscribe and hit the bell icon to get more updates. Thank you. This is Amit Nerulkar signing off. Thank you.